Welcome. Today, I'm going to explain olfactory system, which is the organ system responsible for the sense of smell. To summarize the pathway of the sense of smell, basically the odorant molecules are detected by the olfactory sensory neurons and sent to the olfactory bulb via the olfactory nerve. And then later on to the primary and secondary olfactory cortex of the brain through the olfactory tract. The primary olfactory cortex, as you will later see, includes mainly the anterior olfactory nucleus and the piriform cortex. The secondary olfactory cortex is the orbitofrontal cortex. Now, let me discuss some basic anatomy of the olfactory system. Firstly, there is the olfactory bulb, as you see now, which is the extension of the brain tissue. The posterior extension of the olfactory bulb is the olfactory tract. The olfactory bulb is separated from the nasal cavity via the cibriform plate of the ethmoid. As you can see in this magnified view of the ciliated mucus layer of the olfactory epithelium, odorant molecules comes along with the air, gets dissolved in the mucus secreted by the olfactory epithelium and reaches the olfactory or odorant receptors. Each neuron at the olfactory epithelium level represents a single type of protein receptor. When the odorants bind to the receptors and coupled to G protein, a signaling cascade is activated. This generates an action potential in the olfactory receptors, which travels to the olfactory bulb through axons of the olfactory receptors. These axons form the olfactory nerve. In the olfactory bulb, these axons synapse with second-order neurons. These are mitral cells. The synapse occurs at the structures called glomeruli. You can see glomeruli colored in orange here. Each glomeruli is particular for similar odorant receptors. The axons of the mitral and tufted cells form the olfactory tract, which projects directly to the olfactory cortex. Here is the anterior olfactory neurons. It receives and projects information from the bulb and piriform cortex of the same side, as well as it has connections with the contralateral anterior olfactory neurons, and thus it also regulates contralateral bulb and piriform cortex. On entering brain, the tract divides into medial olfactory tract, the fibers here are shown in red, and the lateral olfactory tract, the fibers here shown in green. The lateral tract enters the primary olfactory cortex, that is anterior olfactory nucleus, and the piriform cortex, and then the secondary olfactory cortex, that is the orbitofrontal cortex. The fibers of the medial tract ends into the subcallosal gyrus or septal area in the frontal lobe. Some of the fibers of the medial tract cross over to the contralateral olfactory bulb and tract and anterior olfactory nucleus.